Hello, hello. Welcome in, beautiful souls. Welcome in. I know I'm late. Thank you. I know. Don't tell me. I was enjoying dinner and then I had to get off my lazy butt and then get ready for stream. And then here we are now. Which I need to remember. I'm gonna remember to turn up the starting music. I think it got like quieted during a test run, and I feel like it's too quiet these days. So, tiny little note for myself. Now my foot itches. Hold on. Can't function. What's wrong with me? How's everyone's week going so far? I know Leisha. For those who don't know, Leisha's my roommate. You've had a headache today, so we didn't get to see your stream today. Hopefully you'll feel better tomorrow and we can enjoy your stream tomorrow. But we've made it to Tuesday this far, everyone. Yay, us. A couple more days in the work week. Eesh. Okay, enough about that. Nobody wants to talk about that. We are going to be playing some more Spiritfarer tonight. Last I had left off, I told you guys I was going to like do some like extra gameplay outside of it, like, because one of, I think it was Bruce and Mickey's quest was to get like 100 carrots or something like that. And so I was like, oh my gosh, that's so many. I'm gonna go grind that off screen, like it'll be fine, blah blah blah. And so I had loaded it up this weekend. And I played for a little bit. And then, sure enough, Bruce and Mickey stopped me when I was at like 50 carrots. And they're like, we didn't say carrots. We wanted peaches. And so now they can't make up their minds. And so apparently it was now for peaches. And then I was like kind of annoyed after that point. Then I was like, fine, I don't want to play right now and I don't want to collect peaches. I mean, I went through the whole process of like, I had to go get like, find peach tree seeds and things like that. Like I did all of that, and then I like sat there and I like played music to help the peach trees grow and all of that, and like to get them to mature faster, to give me peaches faster. It's just a long process. So I like didn't do as much off screen as I was like saying I was going to. So you guys really haven't missed much, I swear. I did nothing really main story wise. I mean, and when Bruce and Mickey, like, they interrupted me. I was trying to feed them and they're like, hey, we didn't ask for carrots. We wanted peaches, by the way. Oh, and feed us, of course, you know, because they're always so rude. But that's what happened. So you're all caught up on what you missed over the weekend. It wasn't much, I promise. Also, why? Sorry, I just realized. Oh, there's the music. I was gonna say, what happened to my music playing in the background? Rude. I know it was playing earlier for a moment and then it just stopped. Whatever. So rude. Yes. Hopefully. Surprisingly, the color doesn't look too awful. It's still a little off, and I don't know if I want to mess with it, honestly, for stream. Though my hair definitely looks way more green, I will say that, so. And my little, Always Mela little logo in the background that Moki got me for Christmas. So, trying to get that color correction working. But but enough preamble. Let's just jump over to the game. Everyone get cozy, get chill. It's so cute up in the little bun. This is because I didn't want to fully brush it out because, well, you saw me, like, you know, before stream. I was a hot mess. I still am a hot mess. I put myself together really quickly for stream, everyone. So it's up in a bun to get it out of the way. And then I have too many little hairs right now. Like, I don't know if it's just, it's probably hair breakage knowing me, but like they just like, it's all over the place. My hair will not fully stay up. Plus it is a higher up bun. Cause I wanted it away from my head or my neck, I should say, but thank you for the compliment. I should just say thank you and not go into a weird ass story. Although my hair is so much worse right now from hiding in the hoodie all day. Well, you have at least a reason because of the hoodie. Mine was because I didn't bother to put a brush through it when I woke up this morning because I've been holed away in my room all day working. And so I was like, I'm just going to be a gremlin all day. Like, if it wasn't for stream, I probably would rarely get put together. I mean, except for the few outings I go out into the real world. But other than that, I'm just a gremlin. And it's fine. And I could be a gremlin on stream. I mean, you guys have seen me a few times as a gremlin live. But I like to try and be put together so that way I feel like, I don't know, kind of like a professional streamer-ish in a way. I don't know. It's a weird mental thing. Probably trauma related somewhere. Who knows? I don't know. What playlist is this actually playing? Oh, the Stream Beats Lo-Fi. I wasn't sure. Gremlins for life. Okay, actual gremlins though, like the movie, that shit always terrified me when I watched it as a kid. I was over in another streamer's chat today. We were talking about, you know, 90s movies and things like that. And I think the first Gremlins is technically an 80s movie, like a late 80s movie. But I think like Gremlins 2 made the list or something like that. And I was just like, fucking hate those movies. Like, I hate, like, it made me permanently hate, like, Furbies. Like, the little, you know, the little robotic little Furby thing with the fucking evil. Reminds me of Gremlins too much. Evil. But human gremlins, it is acceptable. The term is acceptable for that, but it does make me think of the movie Gremlins, and I'm like, nope. Dude, those movies used to give me nightmares, but I love them now. Still probably some like trauma in my brain from it as a child where I'm like, yeah, nope, I'm good. Even as an adult, I'm good. Like, why would I want to put myself through that trauma again and watch it again? I probably haven't watched it now in, God, how old am I now? It's probably been close to 6 years since I last watched Gremlins. Roughly about that time frame, I want to say. And I don't have any desire to watch it again, so meh. All right, I'm going to switch over to frames because to a different frame, to our game, to our beautiful, beautiful game, this stunning, gorgeous game that I really do love, but it is, I mean, we've put in 32 hours and we're 61% of the way. Granted, I think I've said this before. I don't think we're going to 100% it because that's a whole lot of extra side quests and things like that and collectibles. That's too much. That's too much. Yeah, for stream, I mean. I would probably totally do it off stream. And I could still, but once we get through all our friends, that'll be it. So, because I am loving this game, but I do have other games planned for the future that I would love to get to eventually. This game has gone on definitely longer than I had planned, but I did miss quite a few weeks because of life and holidays and other stuff. So this poor game has gotten the brunt of that, which is not fair. It's a beautiful game. I have nothing against this game. There is so much to do all the time, though, in this game. But let's look over our quests real quick. So this is the... Oh, they now want me to talk to them. I might have just collected just enough peaches, finally. Let's see. How many did I grow? Oh, I've only grown 8. So now they're going to tell me it's not peaches. Watch. Just watch. And then Stanley really wants our attention, but I'm afraid we're going to be saying goodbye to Stanley really soon, and I am not ready for that trauma. We love Stanley the mushroom child. Like, the cutest Stanley ever. Where is Bruce and Mickey? Are they in their house, probably? No. Where are they? Oh, that's Stanley. No, no. We don't want Stanley. Where are Bruce and Mickey? They're avoiding me. They know I need to turn in the quest. Are they even apart? No. Yeah, she's having a hard time lately. What the heck? Are they not on boat for some reason? Did they fly off and leave me forever? They must have. What the heck? Okay, well, I don't want to talk to Stanley, but we're going to talk to Stanley. Oh, ta-da, that was amazing, right? I'm sure everyone liked it. Oh, yes, the last thing we did with Stanley was Stanley's little performance, little play, and it was very, very cute. Please, Stella, go and ask around. But wait. Don't flat out ask about it. Don't make it too obvious. Be cool, big cat. Okay. It's building up to being the goodbye for Stanley very soon. I can tell. Hi. Yeah, go down and talk to her. Hi. Excuse you. I was trying to talk to you. Oh, there they are. Where have they been? I could have stayed home and watched the ocean. Oh. Is she talking about Stanley's play? That's so mean. Hi, where are you two going? I need to talk to you. I didn't want to go in there. I'm trying to talk to you. I am trying to talk to you. Why do they do this? Hi, Moki. Land, you fools. What? Let me talk to you. Where are you going? Yeah, you. Gosh. What is your problem? You ruined this whole operation. The buyer is very specific about his cargo. What am I gonna do with carrots or peaches? You're the worst partner I've ever had. You can't even get a simple order straight. He has told me each time what I'm supposed to give him, and he has been wrong each time. My brother would never mess up like this. I don't think this is going to work out. Let's go. You are ready to step up. I shouldn't have trusted you. Oh, shit. Listen, let's go. I know a place. It's called the Everdor. What? We're just saying bye to them? I wasn't even expecting this. That was my bag of chips. This was not what I was expecting at all. We were supposed to be doing this operation with them. Like, what the hell? game is throwing me through a loop. We should go now. No! No! Come back down here. And you're the one who's getting it wrong, not me. Explain yourselves. Stop it. You. Explain. When you think about hospitals, you think about the sounds. The beeping of the machines. Blip, blip, blip. Even with all those machines hooked up to him, my brother's room was silent. And there were flowers. From the boys, from our family, from our new family. It was like a wake. Shit. It felt like a wake. Mom was there every single day and night. She got so exhausted that the doctors told her to go home at night. I tried telling her, Ma, you're tired. Go home. Couldn't get her to move. It took the doctor to give her permission to leave the hospital. You know what, kid? I think that's not hearing him laugh. That really killed me. More than a gun in my mouth. I was the only one who could calm him down for shit's sake. Get him to see reason. Even when he got a boiling red tomato face. And now, I couldn't even do that anymore. Hi, I was trying to talk to you about other things, though. Come back down here, please. And let me feed you. I have garlic bread, I think. I made your favorite. You. Oh, this rain. Will it ever stop? Oh. And then I take off again. Like, I can't have more than, you know, one conversation with you. Oh, nope. I'm falling down. Oh, I heard them. Up above? Yes, they are. I know I have. I do have garlic bread. Your favorite! Okay. I know, you're also hungry. Let's feed you. The meat stew? Well then, I guess we're going to the Everdoor. This was not expected whatsoever. Big Hat. Why can't I eat whatever I want all the time? Big Hat, please. Pretty please. No fair. Mom was also tired of hearing me whine about food. She even had a rule that I couldn't say certain words. Words that next to each other would say what I wanted to eat. Like, oh, I can't say it. Mom would be mad. But I found a loophole. She never said I couldn't ask for French fries. French fries! French fries. Really? Really? They all said they liked it? Really, really liked it? Are you sure, Big Hat? I don't know. I'm just not convinced. I could see it on your face. They told you they liked it, but it was not good. It was terrible, and I didn't do it right. I know it, even if you try to hide it. I just can't do nothing right. I'll never make another play. I hate it. Okay, everyone, emotional damage. I don't have that sound alert set up on my thing, but you know. French fries. Here you go, man. French fries! How did you know? That's my favorite food in the whole world. You're amazing, Big Hat. Wait, are you a chef? Are you sure you're not a chef? Because that's restaurant grade good food. Yum. Okay. Everyone be nice to Stanley. Precious, precious little Stanley. All right, I guess we're off to the Everdoor. I don't even know where I am. Oh, yeah. Well, I need to go. I don't even remember where I needed to go. There was another character I went to go pick up, but then now I don't remember. Jackie. I don't remember where Jackie is. Jackie up here? No. Over here? No? Okay. Where Jackie was. Maybe down south? No, because those still say new. Okay. Well, I guess we're gonna go say bye to Bruce and Mickey. That was very sudden. Like, I'll show you my inventory. Like, I... Not there. One more. See, look. I got to 45 carrots. And then they're like, hold on. What? Like, why would you make carrots? I need peaches. Blah, 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 blah. Went through the whole thing as, like, setting up another orchard, finding the peach seeds, growing the peach seeds into full-grown trees, and then had to wait for them to produce some peaches. And they produced, like, 4 peaches each tree, because there's 2 trees in, you know, the orchard, like the one we're right next to here for the silk fibers. And then that was it. Like, that was where I was like, I cannot do this and sit here and just grind away collecting peaches. Like, I just can't. And then sure enough, they're like, fine, if you can't do it, then we're bailing, I guess. Oh, lightning. I don't know if I needed lightning in the bottle. I don't think I do. I don't think we needed it. Oh, but I should show you my peach orchard. This boat is massive. See? Ta-da, here they are. And I just harvested them at the end of last time I played, so that's why they haven't grown anything yet. Ooh, maybe though. Look at that sunset through the trees. Maybe, though, we'll run into that big owl, though. Again. I'm excited about that. The big creepy owl.
Spoopy.
Nope, well, Miss Olga will probably run into her. Oh yeah, my favorite new mechanic. And the stars come out. Maybe we won't run into her? I guess not. I feel like we should have by now. Oh yeah, we definitely should have by now. Well, I don't think we're gonna make it by the time the boat stops for the night, so. Stopped us actually. No thanks. I don't know if I have anything. Herring cap. one of those. I have a million carrot seeds, though, now. Not a million, but I have far too many, which is annoying. Because I bought, you know, a whole bunch to plant and everything like that. To harvest carrots, and then they're like, nope, never mind, we don't need it. So. Sorry. Thanks, but no thank you. Do I have to switch over to mod view for that, though? It's nighttime anyways. We're fine. Hold on. I do have to switch to mod view. That's so annoying. Hold, please. Are you not gonna let me do that from here? And I don't know why it's not letting me do it. Like, hello? Like, I should be able to do this. Yeah, it's a stupid bot. It's just annoying. I can't ban them for some reason. Oh well. I'm right clicking and it's not. It's like not working for some reason. No clue why. I don't know if it's something in OBS that no longer allows it, but even actually when I go over to my browser version, it doesn't let me do it. And it used to just be a quick, simple little button, and it's not showing up. Oh well, I'm ignoring it. This is taking far too much time. I'll deal with it later. Bots, be warned. I will come for you later. Nobody enjoys your nonsense. Yay. Yeah, and I know it doesn't work on mobile very well, so don't worry about it. It's just a bot, but I don't know why it's not working on my web browser nor in my OBS like it normally does. It's the strangest thing. Wakey, wakey, eggs and bacon. Oh, wait, I don't know if that would no, it wouldn't. They like food, so. Almost there. Here we are. Alright, Scout. We need to talk. I've been... You know how I've been. Want to go somewhere? Yes? Alright. I'm so confused. almost forgot. Listen, let's just get on. I can't do this job without my brother. Let's just get on and talk it through. I didn't plan this life for me and my brother. They used to call me the talker. I could talk your ear off. I would never shut up. However, right now, I don't want to talk. I should just be like my brother and take a moment. Pause and listen. Yeah. And think for a change. Fat chance. At my age, nothing is possible. Nobody changes. Anybody that tells you otherwise is lying. Or trying to sell you something. The only thing I'd rather be is true to myself. That might make me an asshole in the end. That might make me a loyal brother to this man here. None of this shit matters. None of it. Do you know why we're here? It's because I have a small imagination. I can't see beyond my back streets, my town, my friends, my family. More importantly, I can't see a life beyond my brother. If he goes, I go. Funny thing is, he went a long time ago. I just didn't want to admit it to myself. I was holding on to something from the past, my reputation. My house, my car, whatever it was. It was nice while it lasted. It just doesn't change anything. Any way you slice it, we're still Maria's kids from South Broad. Nothing's ever gonna change. Not even in the end. All right, Mickey, deep breaths. Let's go see what everyone has been raving about. I'll send you a postcard, kid. No, the hugs. Oh, thank you, Leisha. Interested to see what their constellation will look like. Oh, I like it. Oh, yeah. Yeah. That one was sad. Oh, we're here. Brothers, I'm guessing. Yeah. This is the story of Mickey and Bruce. Oh, fuck. Sorry, that might have startled me. Obviously. They've never moved like that, so that's why it startled me. Oh, no. I really just did that. Okay. Why is it so hard for me to jump right now? I don't want to have to restart all the way at the bottom. Please don't fall. Pay attention. Jump correctly. I had to give myself a pep talk, okay? Ooh. All this parkour. Hi? Anyone? Nothing? Not here? Oh, sorry. Butterflies are down here. I think that was Mickey? Or was that Bruce?
Yeep.
Oh, I was like, what do I do here? It's a whole story here. Okay. It was Mickey. Tell me more of their story. No? As foretold, here we are again, Spiritfarer. For the last time. Feeble and helpless, a faint murmur drifting in silence. Whispered words, a simple question. Why did you choose this life, Stella? Why did you spend it ushering others through their final moments? Was your vocation an affectionate duty born of compassion? Or a display of selfishness, of everlasting uncertainty? Did you do it for them, or for yourself? To know me and grow accustomed to my presence, to conquer me. Am I less daunting to you now, or am I still a ghastly shadow, a deafening absence? Remember, when your body failed, you knew. You'd seen it 1,000 times. You knew I would come. You fought valiantly, yet suffered all the same. I was deep within your heart, as I had always been. In your final moments, you accept my call. You slowly draw your last breath. And here we are. You know this is the end. But you're not alone. Embraced by the love of your mother, and now your sister. She is here holding your hand. Go now. You are not alone.
Wait a minute, what? What? Holy, our flowers are taking over. I thought that was telling Bruce and Mickey's story. Is this been telling our story all along and I just now realize, like, what? What? I mean, yeah, obviously we had to have been dead to become the new Spiritfarer. Because we're the new ferryman. My brain. doesn't know what to do. My brain doesn't know what to do. Nope. Nope. So wait, are we dead or are we dying? That made it sound like we were currently dying and we needed to let go. The spirit made it sound like we needed to let go and be like, okay, it's time for you to accept your death. Like you've been helping others to do, but it like that's kind of how it sounded. I don't know. And if you know, don't tell me. These are just out loud speculations. Spirit flower. I'm sorry. I feel like... Wait, what? No! Is that our spirit flower? Oh, I'm not touching that. No. Nope. We're not. We're gonna go talk to Stanley. And then we need to go help Jackie. We are not ready to move on. We've got work to do, y'all. I've been thinking about my play and how people didn't like it. It's okay. As Mom says, they are entitled to their hope of onion. Their hope onion. No, I'm sorry. Their opinion, their hope onion. Hope onion. No. That's so cute. Sorry. I'm not angry or sad anymore because of it. I guess there are things in life you can't really control, can you? Like, big hat. No. I'm ready to say goodbye to Stanley now, too. What is happening? This gameplay. This is too much emotional damage, y'all. We should go to the Ember Door. Why would you do this to me, Stanley? I just said bye to Bruce and Mickey very suddenly. And now you, though I felt like yours was going to happen today, actually, Stanley. Like, you were building up to it a little bit there. Bruce and Mickey, that was kind of just a little out of the blue. It felt unfinished, but that's just my hope onion.
Emotional damage.
Nice. Will you come with me? I think I'm scared. I don't think I like new places that much, but if you're with me, I think it will be all right. No, don't be sad. I'm gonna hug you. And then I'm gonna make you french fries for tomorrow. But first, I'm going to give you... What can I give you? Maybe rice? You love rice, yeah. Okay, and then we're gonna make you french fries. French fries. We're totally gonna make you french fries. I don't have any oil. Okay, Stanley, hold on. I need to go make oil for you real quick. Hold on. I think we make that in the crusher. Yeah, I think so. We crush sunflower seeds. Fry up some potatoes. instead of it because he's only gonna be here for the one more day. Damn, this game. So good. So traumatizing. Also, thank you for playing that sound, Leisha. I didn't remember I had that in my blurbs. So, thank you for letting me know that. Fine, we'll just sleep until the morning. Do not touch your flower. We are not leaving. We're not grabbing it. No. It was quite loud. Oh. Thank you. I will turn that down. Thank you. You guys didn't need your eardrums anyways. Gosh. Just compared to you in the game. Oh, got it. Well, I still haven't figured out why. I mean, I'm definitely louder than I used to be, but my mic still won't go up past a certain level, I feel like. Like for my volume, and my mic's right here, so I don't know. I'm sure it's a setting I just haven't done correctly, but I don't know. We need to feed Beverly. Beverly, Beverly, where is that Stanley? Where's Beverly? She's not in her house. Good morning, Stanley. Is she in the archive room, maybe? No, she not. Yeet. My boat is too big. Oh, there she is. She's also really tiny, so it doesn't help. Oh, she's not hungry right now. You know what? Have a hug then instead. What? Oh, what, Beth? Oh, she made us something. How kind. Stanley, where are you now? Okay, you're over here. Hi. From my house, I could always see the snow. Way up in the mountains. Sometimes, there was snow on our house, too. My dad wanted me to go outside with him. We played in the snow. Then he'd run after me. Suddenly, he became a monster. But don't worry, it was all make-believe. I know my dad wasn't a real monster. But when he put his arms up and made a funny voice, I just ran. He chased me. But he couldn't catch me up. Then he became my dad again, and I stopped and he started laughing. I miss the snow sometimes. I don't know, later maybe? You don't want to talk. Fine. You want french fries? You want french fries? I'm not hungry, but did you give me food? That might be why. Yeah, fine. I will wait. We'll wait. Oh, another gift. Fire glow. Nice. Okay. We'll have to actually make some more laksa for her. Which I don't remember. It was fire glow and what in it? Let's look real quick. So that way we have it on hand for her favorite last meal. I'm crazy? Oh, I hear a Tina. She'd be insane.
dilly. Rice flour. That's what we needed, rice flour. And the fire glow. Perfect. She's feeling feisty after her dinner. Oh, nice. She's a feisty girl. Goodness. Well, yeet. Well. What? Look at the flower. It's no longer glowing or pickable. That's weird. And also these, this is a butterfly bush, I think. Which has little butterflies all over it right now, I think. That's hilarious. I'm not 100% sure, but... You know what? Let's go say hi to Albert real quick, and then we'll go drop off Stanley at the Everdoor. I know, I'm totally dragging my feet and stalling because I don't want to say goodbye to Stanley. Albert has for us today, or at least what joke he's going to use. Oh, I hope there's a mirror in that cellar of yours because it's looking good. Har, har, har. That wasn't one of your best, Albert, but it was funny. Solo and the Sun Palette. Ooh. Electrums and pine planks. Ooh, I almost have enough pine planks. And the electrum sheets. I don't remember what all that needed. I know I've made them before. I made them for somebody's upgrades to their house or something. We technically have three more upgrades for boat sizes, but I don't think I actually need a bigger boat. I do kind of want this though. So let me run back to the boat real quick and see what it takes again to make those two sheets. Zinc and silica. Perfect. No, that's the wrong one. Silver. Do I not have silver, though? Do I not have silver? Whoa, I got caught by a roof. Oh. Loxa's done. Beautiful. Nope, down. You meant to jump down, not up. Silver. I'm a little low. We're gonna make it. Sheesh. Oh no. Oh. I was like, it was so close. I'm gonna force it to get over there. There we go. Okay, now I can make this real quick.
Oh, and then we need like one more pine board, I think. This is one upgrade that just makes sense. Make us go a little bit faster, and it looks cool. I still have never understood this little mini game. Finally. Okay, one more. I'm gonna put that there and then I'm gonna run over here. Multitask. Pine, pine, pine. One finalize. Oh, nope, that's terrible, but it's fine. All I need is one. Look at that. Fast as fuck, boy. Sheet. We've got stuff to do. Bloop. I think that's all we needed. And then we can go and... Oh, I once had a friend who cut his own toe. Oh. He had a new one made of rubber. He was called Roberto. You've used this joke before, Albert. You've used this joke before. Ta-da! Cool. All right. I got my upgrade that I wanted. Let's go. Stanley, where are you? Oh wait, actually, we should head there, I guess. Oh. The flower's back. Nope. Nope, we're staying away from that flower. Stanley, where are you? Lunch. Your favorite is for lunch. Yeah. Only the best cooks can make them. You're definitely the best cook on this boat. I'm like the only one. Man, who? Ouch. Sorry, I didn't mean to just punch you all in the ear with my hand on the mic. Gosh. Oh, I can't give him a hug. Look what I drew. I did this drawing for you. A drawing of Giovanni. Fine. We're here, I guess. Everyone, grab your tissues. Prepare to cut the onions. The hope onions. Big hat. Can we go yet? You decide. We're here, aren't we? I already made the decision, I guess. Yes. Thanks. Stanley, are you okay? Oh, I was like, are you struggling on the ladders? You need help? I have my tissue ready. It's probably gonna make me cry because it's very obvious. I mean, we are a child. But Stanley is very clearly a young child who obviously died for some reason. So this is gonna be rough. I almost forgot. I liked it when it was just you and me. Doing experiments and running around chasing dust shades. Don't forget to do that sometimes. I won't be there, but I'm sure it will still be fun. Here we go, everyone. Big breaths in. People can be mean. Really mean. Why do they have to be? My mom is mean sometimes. Just like your friends after my play. It makes me sad when people are mean. And sometimes I cry when I'm sad. But then I remember. I remember what my dad used to say. Stanley, people are not really mean. Sometimes their intentions just take the wrong path. I don't hate your friends. They're not bad people. That's what my dad would say. They just do bad things sometimes. I never wanted to let Mom down or make people not like me. I don't want to do bad things. But sometimes I do, and I always regret it. I don't think that makes me bad. Do you think my mom will be disappointed in me? Disappointed that I had to go? I tried. I really tried. But I don't think I did it. I like it when I win. But I couldn't this time. I think it's okay. It's okay to lose sometimes. I really think it is. I'm really trying to be brave. But I'm really scared. I wish I could be a superhero. I am not crying, y'all. Okay, maybe a little bit. I'm trying really hard not to. I'm just trying to get through the dialogue. Ignore me. I'm tearing up for a moment. Oh, I know. We're not even done. We're not even done yet with him. And I'm like trying to like hold myself together. It's fine. I'm fine. Moving on. Continuing. Whew. And never be afraid.
I hoped so much that this was just a nightmare. If this is a nightmare, why can't I wake up? I was trying. Trying and trying. I wanted to wake up. I always talk to myself. Stanley wants to wake up. But it never worked. I never woke up. It all felt so real. And it made me sad. So sad, I couldn't think of anything other than sadness. You take care of Jacob, okay? Jacob is a good beetle. And he was my friend. This is exactly like in my play. But this time, I'm the lead actor. I will put on a good show, I promise.
Stanley's got us all in the fucking feels right now. I feel strange. I feel cold. I wish Mom was here. And Dad. But you are here, Big Hat. I really like you. I hope it's like falling asleep. Aww. Bye, Stanley. Mushroom cap. That's so cute how they did his constellation. Ugh. That one hurt. I mean, they've all hurt in their own ways, but woof. Everyone needed a good cry tonight, right? Apparently. Look at all the little mushrooms. Aww. Jacob the beetle. Well now. It's just Beverly for right now, though we need to go get Jackie. Who is... I don't remember where. Here? No. Overbrook. Okay. Also, we had... Oh, we gotta go to Nordweiler for Beverly. I'm gonna find another little memory for Beverly. I have no clue where Nordweiler is. Nordweiler, up here. Okay. We'll head there after getting Jackie, I guess. Oh. Uncle O'Toole's thunderstorms. Uncle O'Toole, that was one of those other farewells that were just kind of not messed up, just because it made sense with Uncle O'Toole. Uncle O'Toole did not want to say goodbye, so Uncle O'Toole just left in the middle of the night. And
people do that. And so that's what that's Uncle Tool is the example of that. But it was always like, oh, that hurt. Like, look at Daffodil, our cat. So fucking cute. Oh, look. Some fresh peaches. Not that we need them anymore. Bruce and Mickey left us. Seagull, you can go ahead and take that flower. I don't want it. We're not gonna deal with that. We don't need the trauma. Oh, look at our new figure on the bow of our ship. He's so pretty. Oh, thank you. It's so quiet on the ship now. It's only Beverly and I. Needs to be upgraded. I don't think I have blueprints for anything else. Yeah. I think there's certain blueprints you have to find, you know, in the world, and I don't think I have any left that need to be done. So I did some off of screen. Another storm? How many storms did I drive through? I guess I should turn off that whole interact with your surroundings button, or turn on that button so that way I don't interact with things. Or, you know, I probably actually should have used the bus stop to travel here quicker. But I never think of it. We're almost there now, but I need to remember that. To be honest, I probably won't play too long tonight. Just because I am tired and oh, it's all misty. Even though I know I started late and I apologize, but I am tired. Probably after we get Beverly's photograph or the reel or something to watch. Maybe after that point, after we figure, you know, how we get Jackie and then have Jackie join the boat and everything like that. And then we'll go do Beverly's thing, maybe. And then at that point, I might call it for tonight. And then with the way this is going, unless we collect another spirit friend after Jackie, we may only have next week left on Spirit Fair. That might be... We might be closer to the end than I realized. It's disguising because it said like 61%, but now we gotta find. Oh, Jackie. Hey, wait. Hey, have you managed to put together 5 bags of rice? Yes. Great. Maybe they'll lay off my back for a minute now. Who am I kidding? They won't. Well, Stellars, as usual, you're a lifesaver. I don't know how you do it. Well, better get back to it then. That slopping gonna distribute itself. Come back sometime, eh? I sure can use the break. Are we not going to get Jackie like I thought we were? What the heck? I have been cheated? Wow. Okay, well, we're gonna go to Nordweiler then. We have to get Jackie somehow. It just makes no sense not to. And also, I really want to figure out whatever those the lighthouse things going on are. There's clearly something there, I just don't know what. I'm immensely chipper to see a dynamic young lady being so hard at work. Now that Karen wasn't a true professional, but his manners were, well, a bit cold, if you know what I mean. And he kept everything he found. What a pity. But you're here now. Huzzah, if I dare say. Oh, and don't fret, budding mariner. If ever needed, old Francis will never be too far. But don't let me be an impediment to your appetite for adventure. Go on, set sail, little blue jacket. Want some carrots? I got lots and lots of carrots to sell to you. Lots of carrots. Which is fine to sell back because those seeds were really expensive. There we go. How about some peaches? There, we'll keep 4. Ooh, treasure map. Nothing that good. Alrighty. Well, let's find a bus station. Oh, here's one. And then we'll teleport over to Nordweiler. Seafood and flour. Okay. All right, all right. I'm okay. Nope, that's not what I meant to do. That's Nordweiler, right? Yeah, so right here. Ta-da! Yeet.
Oh, the music's on. Never mind. Can't have my own mini dance party to it. It's snowing! Here we are. Sorry, Daffodil. Did I startle you? Daffodil's hairs were all standing on edge, like, do not drop me into that water. We went on an adventure here with Alice, didn't we? Wasn't this that place or no? Oh, I made it. Oh, that was not it, though. No, maybe this wasn't where we went on an adventure with Alice. Oh, it's locked. Oh, we had a key, apparently. But there was nothing in here. Interesting. Freezing my feet out here. Isn't that big? Where is it? No, not on the roof. Oh, it is inside. You just can't see it when the lights are on for some reason. Well, we got it. That's what matters. That was really weird, though. I won't lie. We have mail. Oh, and it's from Jackie. To whom it may concern, on behalf of the Fart Bank of Fartopolis, of which you are one of the prime benefactors, please accept the enclosed fart dividends. This is not really a letter from the bank, this is from Jackie. And I farted in the envelope. Pranked! Just wanted to tell you that the vending machine has finally been restocked. Come check it out. That was funny. Let's set a course to Jackie. I wanted to get Jackie tonight. Where is Beverly? Oh, she's in there. Good morning. I made you. I made you fisherman's pie. That's not what I wanted from you. I guess I just click on this. Files. Oh, no. Here we go. Strasbourg, 1944. The house is still standing in war-torn Strasbourg. What is that? That view! I love the look of these houses. They are so beautiful. My father was obsessed with architecture. He was a veteran. He went overseas and fell in love with the buildings. Even on the battlefield, he still carried film camera around his neck. He would always be taking pictures. Can you believe that? Despite all the violence and carnage, he still found beauty. Seeing those buildings fall left quite the impact on him. He didn't talk about it much. The war, I mean. Architecture became more than a... He talked about that all the time. Did I ever tell you that I lost my purse with my address book and my mother's brooch? I don't think so. Well, that purse had that photograph inside. I would take it out from... Let me take a little break. Take us to Jackie. We have to prank Jackie back because Jackie gave us an envelope full of fart. Rude. That would actually be a pretty funny letter, though, to send in the mail. So if anyone I know gets one of those from me, this is where the idea came from. Sorry. It's so silly and childish, but it's hysterical at the same time. Oh, Beverly's like, I don't want to talk to you. I'm leaving you. Jackie on our team, and then we'll figure out Jackie's problems, and then we can avoid ours. Perfect. Crispy burlap men. Sounds weird, but okay. Magical. Hey, Smellers. Just thought of that. Did you get my letter? It was pretty good, wasn't it? Hey, lighten up, will ya? I didn't really fart up that envelope. Or did I? Anyway, thanks for the visit. Mm-hmm. Oh, hey, look at that. The ladder is back. Great. I told you, it leads to the room of one of the more difficult patients here. Mm. Scratch that. The most difficult patient. She's got some issues. Like, in the head. Like, difficult issues. She's really a pain. Yeah, okay. I know. It's my job. Don't look at me like that. I'll take good care of her, I promise. Mm-hmm. It's just... Well, it was a nice breather not having to deal with her. The hospital was running so much smoother. Anyway, back to the grind, I guess. If I want to ever have a chance to get on top of this. Hey, Stella, I know you're busy and all with your boat and your fancy duties. Saving the world or whatever you always do. But do you think you could help an old pal? Listen, here's what we're gonna do. I have an extra pager here. It was my colleague's. Well, before he just up and quit mid-shift and left me all alone to manage this shit show. Anyway, take it. That way, if I ever feel overwhelmed, I can just text you. And you can come to the rescue. Mm-hmm. How about it? Yeah. Fantastic. Oh, wow. I feel like a weight has been lifted off my chest. Crap. I almost forgot. What about that snack? Anything good? What? There was just one thing left? What a load of bull. Better be good. What was it? A crispy burlap men protein bar? Ugh. No thank you. That shit's full of unnatural ingredients. My body's a temple. Question of self-respect. Well, really gotta go now. See you soon. Can I feed you? Body's a temple. Can I give you a peach? Mm-hmm. That looks healthy, I guess. Yeah, sorry, Stellars. I don't do fad foods. One day you're eating kale and quinoa, and then suddenly you're in a cult that venerates the juice gods. No, thank you. Not for me. Okay. What about a cup of coffee? Right on. Thanks for the meal. I'm starving. Does not like healthy food. Cool. Well then. Can we go in the building now? No? Well, let's talk to you. This place is falling apart. We need to do something. I can't reach that far up. Jackie's blocking the door. We're not open yet. Trust me, you'll know when it's ready. Will smell a certain kind of way. Okay. Yay. Anything? No? Oh, Beverly's ready for us. I wanted Jackie on the boat, but I guess it's just not going to happen tonight. Oh? Hey, Stella. I can feel it in my bones. The season is about to change. We should take a look at the flowers. Okay. You don't remember? When we were neighbors. We had these beautiful red anemones. I'm sorry. In our garden. You looked so surprised when they would bloom each springtime. You probably thought, it was magic or something. You had the look of, how did they survive all winter? Well, flowers are resilient. They remember that they want to grow, to see the sunlight, to feel its warmth. That's what I like the most about you, Sweet Pea. You were always the brightest part of my day. I'm glad we were neighbors. Neighbors. M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-M-
building looks fancy. It's locked. Let's ride the elevator. See where this takes us. Oh, look. Oh, I just 100% didn't make that landing for some reason. Come back, elevator. Thanks. Take me all the way to the top, please. Sheesh. Sugar cane, large. Crystal chandelier, nice. Anything up here? Anything? Nothing? Nothing cool? Really? Sad face. Oh. Look at that. Finding all the cool shit. I guess I didn't have to take the elevator. I could have just bounced my way up there. Come here, elevator. Go the other way. Come on, come on. There it is. Can you tell someone to unlock the door? I really need to pee. No one has your key, though. I don't have a key. Oh, maybe the shop guy has the key. He always tends to have the key. I don't know then, actually. Okay. Well, sorry, dude. Didn't work out. Look at that boat. But, like I said, I think this is where we're going to call it tonight. Let's turn that down a smidgen. This has been a very emotional night, to say the least. We said goodbye to two friends. Well, three friends, technically, tonight. Bruce and Mickey and Stanley. And we have Beverly and maybe Jackie left. So, and we have not come across any other spirits. So, next Tuesday, maybe our last spirit fair. This has been a great game. It's still stunning and beautiful, even through to the end. Even the emotional damage it is inflicting on all of us
It's still great. Still recommend it. Love it. But yes. Thursday will be more Detroit Become Human. I don't know if we'll finish my second playthrough this Thursday. Depending on how I feel, I may try and log on a little bit early, make for a little bit of a longer Detroit Become Human, because I feel like we're close. Because we just got past the Kamsky area and that whole question, and so now there's not much left. There's probably a good, like, at least 3 hours. But we're not having Connor be deviant. Connor will die. So that'll definitely be a different mission ending for Connor. And then Marcus can end at any moment, honestly. So Thursday could also be the end of Detroit. We will see. And then Friday will probably be more Raft with Leisha, depending on how ordinary Leisha's feeling. But that's our game plan for the week. But it's an adventure already, that's for sure. All right, I'm going to call it for tonight. I hope you all get some rest. Hope you all have a great day tomorrow, hopefully, or at least an okay day. Whatever you can manage. And I will see you all on Thursday. And hopefully I will be early, like I said. If not, at least I'll be on time. I'll really try, I promise. Have a good night, everyone. I'll talk to you later.